Hi, welcome all of you to this a short video talk and a video interview. And we have with us Professor Cabrivas from San Jose State University, California. Ma'am, it's a great honor to have you here.
Thank you.
And since you are on a Fulbright in India, it's a great honor for us to meet and learn something from you, especially for teachers who are watching this video.
I just want to say thank you for giving me the opportunity. This is the closest I'll ever become to a Bollywood actress.
Okay. So, yeah. Now, you've been a professor for long 15 years, and you're specialized in chemical engineering.
That's correct.
And you're also with accreditation agencies. Done great work. You're on Fulbright research. What is the message you want to give to the teachers of engineering education? What is the message?
If I give you one nutshell of message for the Indian faculty, I would start with that: to believe in your students' capabilities.
Believe in students' capabilities.
You have to believe that your students can be great engineers or great business leaders. And you have to help them achieve that. And so you have to figure out what you need to do to achieve it. So that means, you know, there's a lot of new pedagogies that don't really mean doing a lot of extra work. In fact, in some of them actually reduce your workload. Active learning means the students are doing the work. You help them, and you don't. You spend less energy lecturing at the students. But you give them the tools to learn, and then they go out and learn. They learn from projects, they learn from experiments, they learn from doing things on their own, and using their own creativity, developing their own capacities. This is a wonderful new pedagogy, and I can tell you that when I was growing up, and I took one to engineering school, we were also lectured at. And when I graduated, I thought, I never even got hardly any problems 100% correct on tests. And when I finally graduated, I thought, what do I know? I never got any of the problems for that. Go to industry, and I learned from the technicians. And then, you know, little by little, you have to learn by doing. And you have to learn by having the opportunity to practice. So these are the things and they can be done in large classes. There's a lot of things that can be done to help the students really learn to think on a higher level. And that's essential for engineers to be successful.
So, we need to go more with higher order thinking skills?
That's right, that's right.
Applying, designing.
Look at those Bloom's taxonomy. Write your student outcomes for your classes with those Bloom's taxonomy verbs. Help the students to know what the expectations are, help them know what a good example report looks like, but then they should write their own report. No plagiarism. If students are plagiarizing, they should be penalized severely. It's not a matter of getting a bad grade on the report. They should be penalized.
So every project should be assessed on plagiarizing software?
Yep. Yes. Good idea.
Okay. Thanks.
I did.
Yeah.
Sorry about the plagiarism.
No.
Just cut it off.
He came to give you very important information.
Oh, my turn.
Yeah. I'll keep this here. No, we'll find. We'll gather and come back.
Okay.
We'll gather and come back. Did you turn it off?
Yeah. It's going.